Hi students, welcome back to English class. We are discussing the story The Scholarship Jacket, written by Martha Salinas. In the story, the narrator speaks about the obstacles she had to encounter to make her dream come true. Martha comes from a poor family, and as her parents could not afford to keep her, she is given to her grandparents to bring her up. But she is a hard-working girl who has been at the top of the class for all the 8 years. In the Texas school where she studied, there was a custom that the student who maintained the topmost grades for all the 8 years would be awarded a scholarship jacket on the passing out function. The jacket was free, but that year a board member wanted her daughter to get the scholarship jacket. For that, a rule was made that only if the student pays $15, the jacket would be given. The member and some of his supporters among the staff know that Martha is too poor to pay, and thus Joan could get the jacket. When Martha goes home and asks her grandfather to pay $15, he refuses to pay, saying that if the money is paid, it will not more be a scholarship jacket. Let's see what happened then. She walked back and locked herself in the bathroom for a long time. She was angry with Grandpa, although she knew he was right. She was angry with the board. Why did they change the rule when it was her turn to get the jacket? Those were days of belief and innocence. The next day, she went to the principal's office very sad. This time, he did look her in the eyes. When he asked what her grandfather said, Martha told him he would not pay the $15. The principal muttered something. He walked to the window and looked outside. He looked bigger than usual. He was a tall, thin and bony man with a grey hair. Finally, he asked, why wouldn't her grandfather pay? He has a 200-acre ranch. She looked at him, forcing her eyes to stay dry. Then she told him the reason grandfather gave for not paying. She stood up to leave. She told him they would have to give it to Joan. It had just slipped out of her mouth. She was near the door when he called her, "Mother, wait." She turned and looked at him, waiting. What did he want now? Her heart was pounding and something bitter tasting was in her mouth. She thought she would omit. She did not want any sympathy speeches. He sighed loudly and went back to his desk. Then he told her that they would make an exception and give her the jacket. She could hardly believe her ears. She thanked him. She felt great. She did not know about adrenaline then, but she knew something was pumping inside her. She wanted to yell, jump, run, do something. She ran out so she could cry in the hall where nobody would see her. At the end of the day, Mr. Schmidt winked at her and said that he heard that she was getting the jacket. His face looked happy. She gave him a quick hug and ran to the bus. She cried on the walk home again. This time she cried as she was happy. She ran into the field to tell Grandpa. She started pulling weeds. Grandpa worked alongside her for a few minutes. He did not ask what had happened. After collecting a pile of weeds, she faced him. Then she told him what had happened. Grandpa said nothing. He gave her a pat on her shoulder and a smile. He wiped his sweat with a crumpled red handkerchief he always carried in his back pocket. He asked her to see if Grandma wanted any help with supper. She ran back to the house whistling silly tune. Let's see the difficult words and its meanings. Gaunt means very thin. Ranch means a large farm where cows and sheep are grown. Wild means unpleasant. Adrenaline, a secretion of body when we are excited. Crouch means bent down. Crumpled means crushed. Pile means a number of things that have been placed on top of each other. Now it's time for reading. I walked back to the house and locked myself in the bathroom for a long time. I was angry with Grandfather even though I knew he was right. and I was angry with the boat. Whoever they were, why did they have to change the rules just when it was my turn to win the jacket? Those were the days of belief and innocence. It was a very sad day and withdrawn girl who dragged into the principal's office the next day. This time, he did look me in the eyes. What did your grandfather say? I sat very straight in my chair. He said to tell you he won't pay the $15. The principal muttered something I couldn't understand under his breath and walked over to the window. He stood looking at something outside. He looked bigger than usual when he stood up. He was a tall, gaunt man with grey hair, and I washed the back of his head while I waited for him to speak. Why? He finally asked. Your grandfather has the money. He owns a 200-acre ranch. I looked at him, forcing my eyes to stay dry. I know, sir, but he said if I had to pay for it, then it wouldn't be a scholarship jacket. I stood up to leave. I guess you'll just have to give it to John. I hadn't meant to say that. It had just slipped out. I was almost to the door when he stopped me. Martha, wait. I turned and looked at him, waiting. What did he want now? I could feel my heart pounding loudly in my chest. Something bitter and wild tasting was coming up in my mouth. I was afraid I was going to be sick. I didn't need any sympathy speeches. He sighed loudly and went back to his big desk. He watched me, biting his lip. Okay, we'll make an exception in your case. I'll tell the board you'll get your jacket. I could hardly believe my ears. I spoke in a trembling rush. Oh, thank you, sir. Suddenly, I felt great. I didn't know about adrenaline in those days, but I knew something was pumping through me, making me feel as tall as the sky. I wanted to yell, jump, run the mile, do something. I ran out so I could cry in the hall where there was no one to see me. At the end of the day, Mr. Schmidt winked at me and said, I hear you're getting the scholarship jacket this year. His face looked as happy and innocent as a baby's, but I knew better. Without answering, I gave him a quick hug and ran to the bus. I cried on the walk home again, but this time because I was so happy. I couldn't wait to tell Grandpa and ran straight to the field. I joined him in the row where he was working, and without saying anything, I crouched down and started pulling up the weeds with my hands. Grandpa worked alongside me for a few minutes and he didn't ask what had happened. After I had a little pile of weeds between the rows, I stood up and faced him. The principal said he is making an exception for me, Grandpa, and I'm getting the jacket after all. That's after I told him what you said. Grandpa didn't say anything. He just gave me a pat on the shoulder and a smile. He pulled out the crumpled red handkerchief that he always carried in his back pocket and wiped the sweat off his forehead. Better go see if your grandmother needs any help with supper. I gave him a big grin. He didn't fool me. I skipped, ran back to the house, whistling some silly tune. Students, read the textbook thoroughly. If you have any doubts, ask me. Thank you.